Hello friends, today I am going to solve problem number 2 of the textbook. Before solving the problem, we'll see the steps. First, you have to prepare the format as I told you. Then we have to do the marking of trial balance, transfer the trial balance items, transfer the adjustments and close the accounts one by one. So please follow this procedure before solving the problem. In this problem, we are having current account of partners. So instead of capital account, we are going to prepare current account. Let us read the trial balance and decide which items go where. And we'll also read the adjustments and we'll do the marking. From the foreign trial balance of Messrs. Mitesh and Mangesh. So the name of partner is Mitesh and Mangesh. We are required to prepare trading and profit and loss account for the year ended 31st March 2019 and the balance sheet as on that date. Now, we are having stock, that is the opening stock. So, trading account debit, billing, asset, carriage, side, factory insurance trading debit, postage profit and loss debit, bill receivable, asset, debtors, asset, return inward means sales return, purchases, trading debit, audit fees, profit and loss debit, loose tools, assets, manufacturing expense, trading debit, electricity charges, profit and loss debit, general expense, profit and loss debit, export duty, profit and loss debit, cash in hand, assets, bank balance, assets, conveyance, profit and loss debit, furniture, asset, salaries, profit and loss debit, rent, profit and loss debit, and drawings, partners, current account on the debit side. On credit side, we have creditors, liability, sales, trading account credit side, capital of Mitesh and Mangesh, credit side of capital account, we are not having capital account, we will be directly placing on the liability side, capital of Mitesh and Mangesh. Outstanding salaries, here outstanding salaries given in the trial balance, so only one effect and that is liability. Bills payable is a liability, return outward means purchase return and current account balance, Mitesh 3000 and Mangesh 2000 on the credit side. So these are the credit items of the trial balance. Now, we'll see the adjustments one by one. Mitesh and Mangesh are sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:1. So the profit sharing ratio is 3:1. Now, partners are entitled to get commission 1% on gross profit. So that also we'll see later on. Closing stock is 23,700. It has two effects, trading credit and balance sheet asset. Outstanding expense, audit fees and carriage. So we are going to add and second effect we'll show on the liability side. Building is valued at 46,500. So we have to depreciate the building. We have to find out the new value. Furniture is to be depreciated. So we'll depreciate the furniture and we'll have two effects later on. Provide interest on partners' capital. Here also we'll have two effects of interest on capital. And goods of 900 taken by Mangesh. So that is the drawing of the goods. And write off 1000 at bad debts and 3% RDD on the debtors. So these are the adjustments. Now number one is only information. Number two is independent. That we'll come to know what is the commission, we'll calculate and then we'll place on the profit and loss debit side and balance sheet. Closing stock, that is also independent. Now audit fees and carriage. So audit fees and carriage we are marking in the trial balance. So as per these adjustments, we are marking building, we are marking carriage, we are marking debtors, we are marking audit fees, we are marking furniture on the debit side. And on the credit side, there is no such item which needs to be tick marked. Okay. Now, once we are ready with this trial balance, we'll move to the solution to prepare the trading account in the book of Mitesh and Mangesh, trading and profit and loss account for their ended 31st March 2019. So in your notebook, your blank format is ready. You'll be writing the formula. You'll be preparing current account instead of capital account, and you'll be writing the formula of the debtors. Okay, and capital will be placing first. So now let us transfer each and every item of the trial balance. Once stock, opening stock 25,000. So in the trading account, 25,000 is the opening stock on the debit side. Next, we are having building. Building is our asset. Building we are writing in the inner column. So 48,500 is asset. We are writing in the inner column. Then we are having carriage. So carriage in the trading account on debit side, we are going to place. So trading account, debit side, carriage, inner column will write because there is an adjustment. Then we are having factory insurance. Again, trading account debit, factory insurance 2,700. Then we are having postage, that is profit and loss debit. So in profit and loss debit, postage 1,600, we are placing on the debit side. Then we are having bill receivable, asset. So on the asset side, 13,700, that is our bill receivable. Then we are having debtors. So we'll be putting in the formula, 52,200 on the asset side. Return inwards, that is a sales return. So we are going to subtract from the sales return, that is return inwards. Then purchases on the debit side of trading account, 68,900. Next, audit fees, profit and loss debit, inner column. So there is an adjustment. Loose tools is asset. So on the asset side, we'll show the loose tools, 32,000. Manufacturing expense, trading account debit side. So trading account debit side, manufacturing expense, 1,820. Then electricity charges, profit and loss debit, 2,600. Electricity charges. General expense, 3,400. Profit and loss debit, 3,400. Profit and loss debit. Then export duty, again related to office. 1,000, so profit and loss debit, 1,000. Cash in hand, 75,000 is our assets. On the asset side, we'll write cash in hand, 75,000. So again in the balance sheet, bank balance, 29,000 on the asset side. Conveyance, profit loss account debit side. Conveyance the local traveling, so it is an office expense. Salaries, sorry, furniture on the asset side. So we'll show on the asset side, inner column, 64,000. Inner column we are showing. Then salaries, 2,000. Profit and loss debit, 2,000. Then we are having rent, rates and tax. So rent, rates and tax, profit and loss debit, 3,700. So 3,700 we are showing. drawings of Mitesh and Mangesh will write to the current account. So in the current account, on the debit side, drawings of Mitesh is 1200 and drawings of Mangesh is 2200. So the debit side is over. All the figures are appearing on the debit side of trading account, profit and loss account, debit side of current account, and debit side of, that is, asset side of the balance sheet. Only one item is subtracted, that is return inward. Now we'll see the credit side. Sundry creditors 38,000. So on the liability side, 38,000. Then we are having sales 1,75,000. So sales in the trading account 1,75,000. Then we are having capital of Mitesh and Mangesh. So in the capital, in the balance sheet, capital of Mitesh 1,50,000 and capital of Mangesh, that is 50,000. Then we are having outstanding salaries, only one effect, as I told you, on the liability side, 2,000. Then we are having bills payable, 18,000. So bills payable on the liability side. Then we have return outward, 1,800. So we are going to subtract from the purchases, 1,800 return outward. Then we have current account balances 3,000 and 2,000 for Mitesh and Mangesh. So current account balance 3,000 for Mitesh and 2,000 for Mangesh. Okay, so here also we have subtracted each and every item except one, return outward. Otherwise, they are appearing on the credit side of trading, right side of current, or on the liability side. Now let us refer to the sum. Okay, now we'll start with the adjustments. First adjustment is Mitesh and Mangesh are sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:1. That is the only additional information to us. Partners are entitled to get commission 1% on gross profit. That we'll do after completing the trading account. The closing stock is valued at 23,700. So closing stock 23,700, trading account credit side, and here in the balance sheet on the asset side. Same way, our next adjustment is audit fees and carriage, both are outstanding. So outstanding here 600 rupees. Audit fees outstanding 400 rupees. Both we are adding. And both we are placing on the liability side as an outstanding expense. Now, our next adjustment is building is valued at 46,500. So now we are given the new value of the building, 46,500. So the difference is 2,000, and 2,000 is a depreciation. So that 2,000 will be placing here on the debit side of profit and loss account. And we are having one more depreciation, furniture depreciated by 5%. So furniture's 5% is 3,200. So 3,200 we are subtracting. And 3,200 we are showing on the debit side of profit and loss account. Then provide interest on partners' capital 2.5%. Okay, now we are supposed to calculate the interest on the fixed capital. So on 1,50,000 and on 50,000, we should not consider the current account balance 3,000 and 2,000. So on 1,50,000. 2.5% is 3750, and on 50,000, 2.50 is 1250. and both these figures we are going to debit to profit and loss account. So in profit and loss account, interest of Mitesh and interest payable to Mangesh, both are debited here. Adjustment number now 8. Goods of 900 were taken by Mangesh for personal use. So this is nothing but a drawings of a partner. So drawings of goods by Mangesh 900, trading account credit side. And second effect, current account debit side, Mangesh is to be debited by rupees 900. Now we are given write off 1000 as a bad debts and 3% RDD on the debtors. So now we'll write 1000 bad debts, profit and loss debit side, and another 1000 in the balance sheet. And after that, we'll get a new net debtors, 51,200. So we are calculating 3% on this, which is equal to 1536. So this is the new RDD, and that new RDD we are going to add to our bad debts in the formula on the debit side. So all adjustments are over except one, and that is the commission due to partners. So we have completed closing stock, outstanding expense, building, furniture, interest on partners' capital, then drawings of goods by the partner, then bad debts and RDD, all these are completed. Now we'll see the solution. Trading account we are going to close now. Now in the trading account, on the credit side, sales 1,75,000 minus 1,600 is 173,400, 900 and 223,700. On the debit side, purchase minus return outward is 67,100 and carriage add outstanding is 2,380. If we'll see the credit side total, our total is 1,98,000 and the debit side total is 99,000. Now, credit side total is heavy as compared to debit side total. So the difference is 99,000. So 99,000 is a gross profit. Okay. So 99,000 is a gross profit. Then gross profit is brought over here. 9,000, 1% is 990. So we will give commission to both the partners, Mr. Mitesh and Mr. Mangesh, 990 each. So the total amount is 1,980. And this particular amount, 990, is the commission to Mitesh and 990 is the commission to Mangesh. And now we are going to credit the partner's capital account. Mitesh account is credited and Mangesh account is credited. Okay, so that adjustment is over. Now we'll move to close the profit and loss account. Bad debt formula, the total is 2,536. Audit fees, 2,200. We have added depreciation on building is 5,200. Depreciation on capital, interest on capital is 5,000 and commission to partner is 1,980. Now the credit side total is 99,000 and the debit side total is 35,316. So the credit side is heavy. Now we'll deduct the debit side. So the difference that we will get is 63,684. Okay. And the profit we are going to share. We are told that the profit ratio is 3:1. So we are going to share this profit in the ratio of 3:1, which is Mitesh current account and Mangesh current account 47,763 and 15,921. So we'll credit the partner's current account 47,763 and 15,921. And now we will close the current account. So if you are closing the current account, the balance in the current account for Mitesh is 54,000, which we are writing on the liability side. And the balance for Mangesh is 17,061, which again we are writing on the liability side, because this is the credit balance which will which are recorded on the liability side. So now the current account is over. Now on the balance sheet, the capital of the partner is 2 lakh. The current account balance is 71,364. Outstanding expense is 1,000. On the credit side, debtors, outer column, the figure is 49,664. Billing is 46,500. Furniture is 60,000. And the balance sheet total is 3,30,364. And the other side, that is the asset side, figure is also 3,30,364. Okay, friends. So we have completed this sum. And the important points in this sum are, the important point is the interest on capital and the commission to partners on gross profit that you have to calculate. Okay. Other adjustments are normal adjustments. So you can solve this sum and you can do the practice at home. Thank you.